Welcome to The Basement for our monthly live stream. Today we are looking forward to being entertained by one of the stars of the Midlands folk scene. But before we kick off with John, I would just like to say that next month we will be streaming not on the third Sunday of the month, because that's Easter and we should be too busy scoffing chocolate, but on the fourth Sunday of the month instead, so that's the 24th of April. Now with that said, let's go live.
We'll be right back. was called The Fears Come Free. It's the first one, first track off my debut EP of the same name. But this next song is called Road Trip. I'm just going to check the tuning. Okay, just give me 2 seconds. The hazards of writing every song that you do in a bizarre tuning. So this one's called Road Trip. Thank you. you. Thank you, guys. So this next song is called Walk Me, Walk With Me. It's a fairly new song. Let's check the tune. Yeah. And up until last year, I was working as a carer in the day, and I pretty much had to stop doing that. But I suppose it's about the months after when I finished working there. This next song is called Broken Clocks. It's an old song for me. It was written when I was living in Scarborough many moons ago. Let's check the tune again. And I suppose it's about my time in Scarborough, a little bit about that. So Broken Clocks. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, it's a bit of a change of tune, and so this new song is called Is This All? It's a brand new song. I was umming and ahhing as to whether to play this one or not, but I played it earlier to the guys and they're all quite supportive. I don't know if they're lying, but they said yes, you should play this one. So Is This All?
She lived a quiet life. Of human rights to the lost and the found. I feel so indifferent to the people upstairs, and everyone's talking so loud. Is this all there is? Is this all there is? Thank you.
So this next one, and I think we're going to have a little break after this one. But this next one's called Running Free. It's quite a fast picking one. I'm trying not to make too many mistakes. I'm just going to give it another quick tune just to check it's banging before I start.
Why do I keep trying? When you do this all the time, you say you want me, but you're lying. Would you please make up your mind?
John,
hi.
Welcome to the studio, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Not at all. That was a wonderful, wonderful first set. I can't wait to hear the rest of it.
Thank you. Yeah, some strange tunings in there, which does make life difficult at times when you're going from one song to another.
Yeah, it's not just the tunings, though. I mean, you're going from plectrum to sort of claw hammer to strum stuff as well, haven't you? You've got a lot of different guitar techniques going on in that set.
I think so, but I think it's almost sort of part of the writing process. I try to make each song as individual as humanly possible, really. And I suppose that's where the differing guitar techniques come in there.
Okay, and also I suppose, I mean, nominally you call yourself a folk musician, but obviously you're also part of that confessional singer-songwriter idiom as well. And I mean, you talk about Nick Drake, and you talk about, on the one hand, and then also Janssen Rembourn and the folk revivalists of the 60s on the other hand, and you can sort of see bits of that bleeding in, but you've still got very much your own kind of voice here, haven't you?
Thank you, that's great. Yeah, I mean, I started listening to musicians like Bob Dylan, Nick Drake, Richard Thompson. Obviously Pink Moon is the obvious one. I grew up listening to that, and I still listen to it now. And then there's The Black Swan by Bert Jansch, which is an absolutely fantastic album.
Yeah, indeed.
Richard Thompson bought out an album, Front Parlour Ballads, where I think every song apart from the first one is solo, and it's just the most amazing guitar playing.
No, so he's such an astonishing guitar player and performer, and still with us now. And playing regularly.
Yeah.
So what's you know, when we were talking earlier about our folk club experiences back in the day, and I was saying my first experience of Rembourn was when I was 15, I think. My dad took me to an upstairs bar in Burton-on-Trent where some guy had booked him to headline a little folk club thing, and he was just absolute knockout. Astonishing guitar player, and you were saying you had a pretty similar experience.
Yeah, well, I saw him at the Running Horse, and I was quite young at the time. I'd listened to some of his stuff before. I didn't really know what to expect. He kind of sat there with a ciggy hanging out of his mouth, moaning about the guitar tuner that he had on the end. He had this electronic guitar tuner, which he hated and didn't want to use. But he played the most incredible set. And it was just incredible to watch. And from then on, I started to write that sort of style of music, obviously not to the same standard, but it was just an awe-inspiring moment, really, to watch.
Yeah, No, I remember that very well. Still sticks in the mind at this length of time. Mm. And so as time's gone on, you've obviously incorporated more influences and more interests into your music. So what other sort of things are you interested in musically?
I think I like a really wide variety of music. I don't just listen to folk, and I don't just listen to rock or pop. I listen to all styles of music, and I like most styles of music. There's probably a couple, to be fair.
Yeah. It's usually like that, isn't it?
Yeah, and I do try and incorporate some of that into my songwriting as I'm going on.
Yeah, there was a bit of country flavour in the last one, wasn't there?
Absolutely.
Creeping in there, that was really nice.
Brad Paisley, that style of him. Yeah.
So, your EP came out December sort of time, was that right?
That's right.
So,
yeah.
Tell us a bit about your EP and the songs you chose for it.
So, most of the songs in it are old songs. The Fears Come Free was written in Scarborough. I spent quite a long time in Scarborough, and I was really inspired by the local singer songwriters that were there. And I actually did a uni course there, but I stayed on afterwards, and it was really, really inspiring to watch some of these people play. but my by most of my songs, so my EP, The Fears Come Free, they basically were all written during that period of time. The last one that I did, that wasn't written in Scarborough, but it was kind of inspired by that period of time.
So you said you had done a sound engineering course when you were at uni back in the day.
That's right.
So obviously being in a recording studio, you recorded Fears Come Free at Ruffle, didn't you, in Nottingham?
That's right.
A lovely studio with an enviable microphone collection.
Yeah.
Mm. So how do you find it trying to be sort of, do you want to be behind the desk when you're tracking your own music? Is it okay just to hand over responsibility for that to somebody else when you're... And you're obviously an experienced sound engineer as well.
I don't know if experienced sound engineer is. I think that's given me a bit too much credit. But I think when you're working on your own stuff, it's too easy to be overly critical of every single thing.
Yeah, of course.
And then you never end up getting anything done because you're like, well, this doesn't sound particularly great, so I need to go back and change this and change that. Whereas I think if you've got an experienced sound engineer that will say, actually, that's okay.
That's pretty good. You can see the big picture a bit more. Yeah, of course, we do, don't we? We dive right into the minutiae of everything we
absolutely.
Do.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's difficult to get your head out of that and into to view your own music from a listener's perspective.
Certainly. And I think, when you're on the 500th take of your own song, it starts to get a little bit a bit much.
Especially if there are other people in the room with you. Yeah, notorious.
Not again!
Yeah. So, as well as being a solo artist, you play in a band.
Yeah, that's
right. And you've done various band work. So, what's it like then playing in... tell us a bit about that.
So, I play in a band called Exhibit A. We're a five-piece. We play all over the country. We do mainly biker rallies, so that's what we head towards. We're a rock and punk band. It's all covers, and it's amazing. It's fantastic. Great guys in the band.
We cut our teeth on the bike scene as well, and there's more of a crossover between like the sort of rock and the folk side of that than you might think as well, isn't there?
Absolutely. I mean, we were saying earlier about Led Zeppelin, weren't we?
Yeah.
And the crossover that they had with their acoustic stuff, like going to California and
Zeppelin 3.
Lots of that, which is just absolute genius. And I think a lot of folk artists took quite a lot from that period of time and from the rock side of things as well as the folk side.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, those two scenes were thriving so much hand in hand in London and the United States at the time, weren't they?
Absolutely.
So, you play bass, you said, in your band. Do you play anything else, instrument-wise?
I play a little bit of piano, but it's a bit like watching Les Dawson on the piano, to be honest. I'm pretty bad at it. I use it as almost like a songwriting tool, to be honest with you.
Yeah, sure.
So, I play a bit of piano. I play a tiny little bit of drums, so I can just about hold a 4/4 beat together. Bass, guitar... But strangely enough, not really an electric guitar player, to be honest with you.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's why you play bass in the rock band.
I think it is, yeah. But
is it the same manic finger picking?
Yeah.
Or are you just sort of keeping the pulse?
The guitarists in the band are really good, so I wouldn't be able to. Yeah. I'm quite happy on the bass.
Fair enough. Obviously, lockdown has put a bit of a dampener on our ability to gig and a lot of our musical career. How's that been for you? What's lockdown been like?
Strangely enough, to be honest with you, although lockdown was obviously a complete nightmare for everybody, the Caspar that's in Loughborough were holding weekly virtual open mic nights, which were absolutely amazing. And these were becoming more and more popular as time progressed.
Yeah, sure.
And it actually really pushed me to write songs, and I suppose it's partly to do with the support that I got from those guys during that period of time that I was able to go out and do gigs after lockdown. So in actual fact, although the lockdown was in essence a complete nightmare, the music side of it was huge.
Streaming was a total lifeline for so many of us during that period.
Yeah.
And it wasn't a thing we'd even thought of prior to lockdown, and now here we are doing it every month, and obviously you've become something of a veteran streamer yourself by now.
Yeah.
So it's a slightly different experience, though, isn't it, to be singing in front of a bunch of cameras and without the audience interaction.
It really is. It's bizarre because I don't know what, if you're expecting an applause or what from a bunch of cameras around you. But it can seem a little bit isolating when you've finished your song and you're finished and right. Silence.
They don't have much of a vibe or much of an energy to give back to you, do they?
Where is that?
Cameras in the room, I have no idea. It's probably just too, this is too much in its infancy. They will probably develop the virtual reality interacting camera before much longer to help us out with that.
Yeah.
So, looking forward to 2022, what have you got planned for the rest of the year in your musical life?
So, I mean, with the band, we're out a lot. We've got a lot of gigs planned. But I've got another gig coming up in June, I think it is, at the Caspar, which I'm really looking forward to. Cool. I've put in some applications to various festivals and stuff, so I'm just going to see.
Is that a solo gig at the Caspar?
Yeah. And I'm hoping to do some more recording. I'm building towards an album, hopefully incorporating other instruments as well, other musicians maybe.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So plenty on the cards.
Yeah. Exciting time.
Great. Look forward to it. Look forward to hearing more of it.
Yeah.
Okay. You. Well, been fantastic chatting to you.
Yeah.
But we and they are here for the music. So shall we kick into set two?
Certainly will do. Thank
Marvelous.
You. Thank you for having me, guys.
Nice to. Yeah.
Thank you for having me. The next song that I'm going to play is called Girl in the Summer Dress. Remember the time when the stars seem to fill your eyes.
take your pills and follow me. Well, I've been dreaming of the thought you tell. Read our cards and tell me where. Should be back in the basement where the people live. Look into the sky, dreaming of another life. There ain't no time for you, me anymore. Just the glove I could. Take your pills and follow me. Take your pills and follow me. Take your pills and follow me.
Thank you. So this next song's called You. I might have to just do a quick tune because I'm changing the pickup and my intonation isn't great on my guitar. So this song, I suppose, is a bit of a, well, it was written about a period of time that I had when I was 17 years old, going on to 18, and I had quite a nasty accident whilst out in Germany, and I suppose it's a bit about that. Journey's end. There's nowhere left to run. Well, I've seen where you live. So when I was doing the EP, I decided to put some videos together. Basically, I set up a load of, I was talking to these guys about it earlier, but I set up a bunch of iPads and iPhones, and then recorded some songs and trying to promote it a little bit. I then went to a royalty free website and then took some clips, and so this next song was one of the songs that I used. It's a blues one. It's called Solo. Wasted in the mornings, wasted in the night, your secret life confession took everything I had so low. Why feel so low? So low. So this next song's called Angeline, quite an old song really for me, I suppose, a bit of a change of pace.
At a seaside town amongst the ruins, so I flew your side to England. Oh, is it real? You've gone away. Where did you go? I've been good for you. courtesy sat down to all the runaways. It broke the loads of his way. Oh, is it real?
So, a couple more songs. This next one's called Lipstick Stains and Smokes. I usually say what this song's about, but I'm not going to as it's being videoed. But it's about when I was a teenager, I suppose.
Get out of
So I've got one song left, if that's all right. We're okay for time? Yeah. Okay. I just wanted to say thank you so much to everyone here at Instrumental Music, and it's been an amazing day. If you ever get the chance to come and play here, they're really, really cool, amazing people. So you should definitely come and do it and check out all the stuff. The album is really great. So this last song is called Sunnyside Street.
They don't belong.
for having me. Really enjoyed it. It's been brilliant. Yep. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much for joining us. That's all we have time for today. Thanks very much to John for his wonderful music. And we will see you again on the 24th of April for Licata. See you then.